Dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Myself, Dr. A. Vijaya Chitra from Sri Narayana Guru College, Department of Microbiology, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu. Today we are going to see the module Convention on Biological Diversity. The biodiversity, it is the foundation of ecosystem services to which human well-being is intimately linked. No feature of Earth is more complex, dynamic, and varied than the layer of living organisms that occupy its surfaces and seas, and no feature is experiencing more dramatic change at the hands of humans than this extraordinary, singularly unique feature of Earth. This layer of organisms, the biosphere, through the collective metabolic activities of its innumerable plants, animals, and microbes physically and chemically unites the atmosphere, geosphere, hydrosphere into one environmental system within which millions of species including humans have thrived. Why is biodiversity important? And how does biodiversity have an impact on Earth? So the main function of the biodiversity is to maintain the balance of the ecosystem. The maintaining in sense where it recycles and the storage of nutrients, combating pollution, stabilizing climate, protecting water resources, forming and protecting soil and maintaining eco-balance. The second point comes the use of biodiversity is that where there is a provision of medicines and pharmaceuticals, food for the human population and animals, ornamental plants, wood products, breeding stock and diversity of species, ecosystem and genes. And the third, the benefit of the biodiversity is the social benefit where recreation, tourism, culture value and education and research. So the main objective being the rational or to learn the rational of Convention on Biodiversity and to understand the conventional protocols, to know the operational structure and the bodies involved in the convention, and to know the imminent steps taken to conserve biodiversity. When does or what made the Convention on Biological Diversity to accomplish or to come into force? In 1992, at the Rio de Janeiro, there was an Earth Summit, and the Convention on Biological Diversity was signed by 150 countries in 1992 in that Earth Summit. It is an international agreement, and the Rio Earth Summit is officially called the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. Coming to the objectives of the Convention on Biological Diversity, the main objectives of the convention include conservation of biological diversity, the sustainable use of its components, and fair and equitable sharing of the benefits that arise out of the utilization of the genetic resources. According to the convention, biological diversity means the variability among living organisms from all sources, including the intralia, terrestrial, marine, and other aquatic systems and the ecological complexes of which they are part. This includes diversity within species, between species, and of ecosystem. Article 3 of this convention says that the states have sovereign right to exploit their own resources within their jurisdiction or control, but without causing damage to the environment of other states or areas. The convention shall bring each contracting party to cooperate with other contracting parties directly or through international organizations so that the conservation and sustainable use of biological diversity. Each member should party or each should develop national strategies, plans and programs at national, state and local level for conservation of biodiversity. Coming to the Article 8 and 9 of the Convention, it gives emphasis on in situ and ex situ conservation of biological diversity. In situ and ex situ, they play a very major role in conservation of biological diversity where the national parks, laboratories, everything come into plan. And Article 10 of this convention details about the sustainable use of components of biological diversity. The measures include the integration of conservation and sustainable use, development of measures to minimize impacts on biological diversity, use of local people for remedial action of degraded area, which is a very, very important thing, and to develop cooperation between government authorities and private sector to conserve biodiversity areas. And coming to in accordance or the Article 12 of this convention, the member party can establish and maintain programs for scientific and technical education. The member party may educate and train in the areas of identification, conservation and sustainable use of biological diversity. Article 13 of this convention is with reference to public education and awareness. It includes promotion and encouragement of procedures for conservation of biological diversity and the need for cooperation of state and international organizations in developing educational and public awareness programs, which becomes a very, very important thing. Next, coming to the structure of the Convention on Biological Diversity. The structure means the Secretariat, the Conference of Parties and other subdivisions in this. So among all these things, the Conference of Parties is the main thing. The Conference of Parties, which is simply called as the COP, is the governing body of the convention. The function of the COP is to implement the decisions which are taken in periodic meetings. After the Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit in 1992, 13 COP meetings were held, which also includes one extra COP which is held in Cartagena, Colombia. The other body or the another structure which comes under the convention is the subsidiary body on scientific, technical and technological advance. Article 25 of the CBD, that is the Convention on Biological Diversity, says or it has created this Intergovernmental Scientific Advisory Body. The main function of this body is to assess the status of biological diversity and of the measures taken to conserve it. So this body, it measures the conservation process which are taken. We have the Conventional Biological Diversity Secretariat. The secretary of this convention on biological diversity is in Montreal, Canada. The main functions of the secretariat are to organize meetings, prepare reports, assist the member countries in execution of programs, to coordinate with other international organizations and collect and disseminate information. These are the main functions of the secretariat. Next, coming to one of the important thing which is called as the working group on Article 8J. It involves the use of local communities in identifying, preserving and maintaining biodiversity because the local people know more about biodiversity. So it gives more emphasis or the emphasis should be more given to the local people in preserving and maintaining the biological diversity. And Article 8J of the Convention on Biological Diversity Parties says that to respect, preserve and maintain the knowledge, innovations and practices of indigenous and local communities relevant for the conservation of biological diversity and to encourage equitable sharing of benefits which are arising out of the use of the biological diversity. And the next thing coming to or the thing which has given a protocol apart from the Convention of Biological Diversity, we have another protocol called as the Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety. It is also known as Biosafety Protocol. This protocol was adopted on January 2000. So this is a part of the Conference of Parties. This protocol, it aims to protect biological diversity from the potential risk of living modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology. So we know that biotechnology comes or makes new organisms, modified organisms, and we have many new or type of varieties which are included into the ecosystem. And when these new types of organisms are introduced into the ecosystem, this will have an imbalance. So in order to meet that, this particular convention is brought up. So it mainly incorporates for the procedure for import of the living modified organisms. And the number of parties which have signed this convention is 171. In accordance with the precautionary approach contained in Principle 15 of the Rio de Declaration on Environment and Development, the objective of this protocol is to contribute to ensuring an adequate level of protection in the field of the safe transport, handling, and use of living modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology that may have adverse effects on the conservation and sustainable use of biological diversity, taking also into account risks to human health and specifically focusing on transboundary movements. On 29 January 2000, the Conference of the Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity adopted a supplementary agreement to the convention known as the Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety. The protocol seeks to protect biological diversity from the potential risk posed by living modified organisms resulting from modern biotechnology. It establishes an advanced informed agreement called as AIA procedure for ensuring that the countries are provided with the information necessary to make informed decisions before agreeing to the import of such organisms into their territory. The protocol contains a reference to a precautionary approach and reaffirms the precaution language in Principle 15 of the Rio de Declaration on Environment and Development. Now we'll see what is biosafety clearinghouse. So the biosafety clearinghouse is one or which the main function is to facilitate exchange of information on living modified organisms. And it also assists the countries to act in accordance with the protocol. It provides scientific, technical, and environmental information to the member countries. And India has complied to the biosafety protocol on 17 January 2003. And what is the strategic plan for the Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety? So that is a strategic plan. They have devised a strategic plan for the Cartagena Protocol on Biosafety from the period 2011 to 2020, and it was adopted in November 2010 in Nagoya, Japan. The plan has five focal areas, out of which the second and the fourth, they are very relevant to the biosafety clearinghouse, which includes the capacity building and information sharing respectively. Capacity building. What does capacity building mean? It means that it is a strategic objective to ensure that the biosafety clearinghouse is easily accessed by all the stakeholders, which means that all the established stakeholders, both in the developing countries as well as in countries which have been developed and also with countries which have economies in transition. And the focal area 4, which includes the information sharing. So that includes the objective of the information sharing is to enhance the availability and exchange of relevant information. So the relevant information should be exchanged. That is one of the main objective of this biosafety clearinghouse. So apart from the Cartagena protocol, which is based upon the living modified organisms, another protocol which was devised, and that is called as, or that protocol is named as, Nagoya Protocol. This Nagoya Protocol was adopted on 29 October 2010 in Nagoya, Japan. The Nagoya Protocol, it gives access to genetic resources. The protocol, it is a protocol on access to genetic resources and the fair and equitable sharing of benefits which are arising from the utilization to the Convention on Biological Diversity. It is an international agreement. Its objective is the fair and equitable sharing of benefits which arise from the utilization of genetic resources. Thereby, it contributes to the conservation as well as to the sustainable use of the biodiversity. India has signed the protocol on 11th May 2011. So, under this Nagoya Protocol, from now there is a platform for exchanging information that is called as the Access and Benefit Sharing Clearing House, which in short is called as the ABS Clearing House. What is the use of this ABS Clearing House? It is a platform for exchanging information on access and benefit sharing, which is established by Article 14 of the protocol as part of the clearing house of the convention established under Article 18. The ABS Clearing House is a key tool for facilitating the implementation of the Nagoya Protocol by enhancing legal certainty, transparency on procedures, benefit sharing for monitoring the utilization of genetic resources along the value chain through the internationally recognized certificate of compliance. By hosting relevant information regarding ABS Clearing House will offer opportunities for connecting users and providers of genetic resources as well as on associated traditional knowledge. Now we have seen the Cartagena Protocol, we have seen the Nagoya Protocol, and now there comes a supplementary protocol on we can say that is mainly based upon the Cartagena Protocol. So it is called as the Nagoya Kuala Lumpur Supplementary Protocol. The Nagoya Kuala Lumpur Supplementary Protocol on liability and redress to the Cartagena Protocol on biosafety. This is the full name of the protocol. The main feature of this protocol is a clear framework governing damage resulting from the authorized use of living modified organisms. So as we all know, liability means it is normally associated with or when applicable to law, it is nothing but a compensation for damage. So when a particular thing is given, it is liability means that a compensation for damage which results from an action for which the particular person is responsible. In liability and redress, in context of the protocol, it concerns the question of what would happen if the transboundary movement of living modified organisms has caused damage. So the issue of liability and redress for damage resulting from transboundary movements of living modified organisms was one of the themes on the agenda during the biosafety protocol, and they weren't able to bring out or they didn't come to a conclusion about what would happen because of these living modified organisms, and they also considered that this matter has to be considered very critical and urgent. They enabled with this particular article, that is a supplementary article, is included in the final text of the protocol, which comes under Article 27. Next, we are going to see the United Nations Decade on Biodiversity. So we have seen the Nagoya Protocol, the Cartagena Protocol, and also the supplementary protocol. So the United Nations in October 2010, at the 10th meeting of the Conference of the Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity in Nagoya, Japan, the governments or the people or the parties who have signed in that particular agreement, they agreed to the strategic plan for biodiversity 2011-2020 and its HE biodiversity targets. The goal of the United Nations Decade on Biodiversity is to support the implementation of the strategic plan for biodiversity and to promote its overall vision of living in harmony with nature. On 22nd December 2010, the UN declared the period from 2011 to 2020 as the United Nations Decade on Biodiversity. 2010 was the International Year of Biodiversity. The main agenda behind the HE biodiversity targets or the mission is that to hold the laws of biodiversity and to ensure that by 2020 ecosystems are resilient and continue to provide essential services. The vision of the particular missions is that to facilitate ecosystem services and conservation of biodiversity by 2050. So based upon this, the United Nations have devised some strategic goals. So the strategic goal A is that to address the underlying causes of biodiversity loss by mainstreaming biodiversity across government and society. The strategic goal B, to reduce the direct pressures on biodiversity and promote sustainable use. Goal C, it is to improve the status of biodiversity by safeguarding ecosystem, species and genetic diversity. Strategic goal D, it is made to enhance the benefits to all from biodiversity and ecosystem services. And strategic goal E, it is to enhance implementation through participatory planning, knowledge, management and capacity building. So this is the current agenda, or that is the HE's target is the current agenda. And to based upon this, there was another plan which was introduced, and that we call it as the BioBridge. The BioBridge action plan was developed to guide the activities and operations of the initiative for the period 2017. The BioBridge action plan has been prepared by the Secretariat with the support of the Quebec Center for Biodiversity Science and UNEP World Conservation Monitoring Center. It was launched at the 13th meeting of the Conference of the Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity, 13th meeting in December 2016 in Cancun. The BBI was established by the Government of the Republic of Korea to contribute implementation of the Strategic Plan for Biodiversity 2011 to 2020 and the achievements of the HE biodiversity targets as well as national biodiversity strategies and action plans through enhancing technical and scientific cooperation. The vision of this biological bridge is that to scale up technical and scientific cooperation among parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity and its protocols through regional and global partnerships and networks in order to achieve their national biodiversity targets and contribute to the achievement of the HE target. Realizing this vision, it requires the support and participation of all the parties and stakeholders and adoption of a flexible and adaptive approach which will ensure that the technical and scientific cooperation focused activities continue to meet the need of parties in the long term. So the mission of the BBI is to foster and facilitate the technical and scientific community among countries and institutions in order to halt the loss of biodiversity and ensure that the ecosystems are resilient and continue to provide essential services. The BioBridge Initiative, it is an overarching program that is focused mainly on catalyzing and facilitating the technical and scientific cooperation among the parties of the Convention on Biological Diversity and its protocols, Cartagena Protocol and the Nagoya Protocol. The BioBridge Initiative facilitates technical and scientific cooperation among parties by linking parties that have specific technical and scientific needs with parties or institutions that are able to provide the necessary technical support and resources to meet those needs through mutual partnerships, and creating a space for countries and institutions to share knowledge, good practices and lessons which are learned by with each other. Next, coming to the national biodiversity planning. So as now each and every country, they have to follow a national biodiversity planning, which means that the Convention on Biological Diversity has Article 6, which says that the countries who have signed in it in the convention have to prepare national strategies. The Article 6 of CBD, that is the Convention on Biological Diversity, emphasizes on the preparation of national biodiversity strategy to protect biodiversity. The national biodiversity strategies, action plans or programs have to be developed for the conservation and sustainable use of biodiversity. Should also prepare national reports. And this national reports, it comes in accordance with the Article 26 of the Convention, where the parties, they prepare national reports on the status of the implementation of the convention. Now we have seen about what are the conventions or what are the additional conventions which has arisen with the Convention on Biological Diversity, and that is with Convention on Biological Diversity, the two protocols which have arisen are the Cartagena Protocol, the Nagoya Protocol, and after that we have the Supplementary Protocol. And based upon that, we have the United Nations Decade on Biodiversity, where the period starts from 2011 to 2020. And we have the BioBridge Initiative Program. And what is the role of India in making or in following these conventions? So now we are going to see about the position or the status of India in Convention on Biological Diversity. India, being a member party of this convention, it devised the Biological Diversity Act 2002 and the rules for it in 2004 with the following objectives. Number one, the conservation of biodiversity. Number two, the sustainable use. And number three, it is the access and benefit sharing. So brothers, what is the operational structure in India? So the opera, because in India we have state level, national level, and we have local level. So we have many levels of control over many authorities. So the operational structure includes a national biodiversity authority, which is at a national level, a state biodiversity board, which is at the state level, and a biodiversity management committee at a local level. What is the role of the National Biodiversity Authority? So it is an autonomous body under the Ministry of Environment and Forest. It is established in accordance with the Biological Diversity Act 2002 of India, and this has its headquarters in Chennai. And the United Nations giving much importance to biological diversity to proclaim a day for the biological diversity, and that is 22nd May, which is proclaimed as the International Day for Biological Diversity by United Nations. And this year's theme, that is the theme of 2017, is it is an international year of sustainable tourism and development. And with this, we come to the end of the conventions, the protocols, and other developments which have taken place. In order to give you more idea about the biodiversity or other conventions which have a role, I will list out certain conventions or the related conventions on biodiversity. So the other conventions on biological diversity include the Convention on Biological Diversity, Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, and Convention on the Conservation of Migratory Species of Wild Animals, the International Treaty on Plant Genetic Resources for Food and Agriculture, the Convention on Wetlands, which is popularly known as the Ramsar Convention. Next, the World Heritage Convention, WHC, and we have the Convention, International Plant Protection Convention, IPPC. So these are the conventions which give more importance to biodiversity. So we have come to the conclusion part of this convention on biological diversity. So now we have understood how biodiversity plays a very, very important role in conserving or in maintaining the ecosystems. So we have to follow all these conventions and the methods and the procedures and the programs, the plans which are established by the UN, by the national authorities, by the state government authorities, as well as by the local authorities, so that we can protect the biodiversity. Biodiversity is very, very essential for the human life to sustain. Without biodiversity, we are nothing. So we have to protect biodiversity, and protecting biodiversity is in the hands of us.